My name is Benaya and I'm in the 11th grade of SPH. The name of my project is Multipurpose Drone Development. I chose this project because I have an interest in aeronautics and I wanted to learn more about the topic while applying what I learned at the same time. The main goal of the project was to improve the efficiency of an unmanned aerial vehicle. To accomplish this, I worked with Cerita Boat Indonesia. I then used investigation and simulation to try to improve the efficiency of their drone by using 3D software to find which aerofoils and which designs would be the most efficient for the purpose of the drone. Further investigation into the efficiency of unmanned aerial vehicles is especially important in Indonesia, as it is a fast and relatively cheap way of light transportation and surveillance.
Yang dibuat Ben adalah sebenarnya robot. Robot terbang. Ya kan? Karena dia dalam tahap belajar, jadi dikuasai dulu karakter terbangnya. Kemudian tahap berikutnya adalah dia mau apa dengan pesawat itu? Mau kirim barang, mau membentuk pemetaan, melakukan surveillance, itu bisa dilakukan tergantung apa yang akan diprogramkan ke pesawat ini. Dia kan merencanakan pasti melihat apa yang ada, kemudian dibaca sesuatu, mungkin nggak ini direalisasikan, kemudian diskusi dengan saya, diskusi dengan teman-teman. Pertama-tama malah kita nawarin, Ben, beli aja pesawatnya. Nah, Ben seminggu berpikir, terus diputuskan, enggak pak, kita enggak mau beli. Saya bilang, oh hebat, saya bilang. Nah, kalau gitu, kita buat dong. Iya buat. Nah, didesain, itu kan pesawat didesain. Didesain dari scratch. Jadi dihitung, seperti layaknya bikin pesawat kan. Kita selalu menghitung itu aerodinamis. Cuman kalau di pesawatnya dia ini karena kecil, enggak terlalu kritikal, kita enggak terlalu banyak menghitungnya. Yang penting jenis sayapnya ini, nakas sekian, daya angkatnya sekian, udah. Tapi Ben pengen ada empirisnya, ada gimana sih cara menghitung sayapnya, lift, drag, rasio, dan lain-lain gitu kan. Ben ada softwarenya, dia hitung balik gitunya, perhitungan sayapnya. Saya kira itu bagus. Saya sendiri waktu zaman dulu nggak kepikir buat ngitung begitu. Artinya Ben punya keinginan untuk lebih dalam, lebih jauh tahu mengenai aeronautik.
This project has been beneficial to me as I have been able to learn aeronautics while at the same time applying it in a practical project. Through this project, I have increased my knowledge of the field of aeronautics while also increasing my interest to pursue further projects in this field. Throughout the process of this project, my mentors have been very helpful to me. Firstly, they assisted me in construction of the airframe, as I had no experience in this before. And they also helped me construct the electronics for the plane, which I also have never done before. And most importantly, they explained to me the uses and the benefits of unmanned aerial vehicles and in what ways this project can be expanded. I would like to thank Pak Eden, Pak Budi, SPH Applied Science Academy, Cerita Boat, and all my mentors for their guidance and the opportunity to do this project. Through this project, I have been able to learn more and innovate in this field.
Kalau untuk Ben sendiri ya, nggak terpaku atau terfokus oleh sesimpel itu. Jadi pemikirannya jauh, walaupun di baru-baru. Tapi memang saya berharap kan ini gabungan dari elektronika, mekanika gitu kan, sedikit banyak dia harus belajar juga itu biar biar ada pemahamannya lebih dalam lagi. Dan saya kepengen band bisa menikmati, bukan hanya bisa membuat, tapi bisa menikmati, bisa menerbangkannya, ya kan? Kemudian bisa membuat yang lain-lain lagi, gitu loh. Nggak cuma sebatas ini.
After building the UAV and optimizing it for range and stability, an autopilot was finally added to the UAV so it could maintain a stable and precise directed flight. While testing the UAV, we also found that the chosen aerofoil design was suited for range and stability as it was able to keep altitude with only around 30% of engine power and 15 to 20 meters per second ground speed, which is optimal for uses such as long range surveillance. The UAV has also been tested with a GoPro mounted on the bottom of the fuselage, which was able to record footage of the ground below, which could then be used to create an aerial map. I would like to thank Pak Eden, Pak Budi, and Pak Hafid for helping me make this project possible. Through this project, I learned the basics of aeronautics, especially on the topic of aerofoil optimization. The knowledge and experience that I gained from this project will continue to be useful to me as I am studying the subject of aeronautical engineering in university. Right now, the drone is capable of aerial surveillance using a lightweight bottom-mounted camera, as a GoPro mount has been attached to the bottom of the fuselage. This drone could be further improved to include better cameras and surveillance systems if it is to be used for that purpose, or could also be fitted to carry cargo and drop cargo. This is a multi-purpose UAV, so further work could be done to adapt it to a variety of applications which require range and stability.